Although George Gamow thought information would be stored most efficiently in the overlapping model, in reality, the triplet code is read in a non-overlapping fashion, actually the less efficient method. Now, obviously, if we were designing a system, this doesn't make a lot of sense as far as efficiency sake, right? We can get more information stored in this overlapping model than compared to this non-overlapping model where each codon has to be its own individual or its own discrete unit. And it turns out that this messiness, this inefficiency, is a result of evolution, and in particularly some molecular constraints of the system that are slightly beyond the scope of our material here. So this means that we're left with 64 possible combinations of three nucleotides, and each set of three is referred to as a codon. So we have 64 possible codons, and a codon is just a sequence of the three nucleotides, which are part of the genetic code. And it took years of experiments to finally determine exactly which codons code for which amino acids. And this information is referred to as the genetic code. Although it took many years and a lot of hard work to come up with this information, I'm giving it to you right here, summarized for free in less than a few seconds. Here is all of the magic of the genetic code. You're going to have to get quite familiar with this table, so I hope it doesn't scare you away too fast. I've color-coded it to try to make it a little simpler for you, and I'll explain to you how to read it in just a moment. But the first thing I want you to do is actually just stare at it for a minute. Try to read it. First letter in the codon, second letter in the codon, third letter in the codon. We have UCAG, UCAG, and then each combination for every row here. And then you can see each codon is spelled out in the individual box. And then beside it is the amino acid that it codes for. What patterns or features stand out to you about this genetic code? Is there anything interesting that you notice? I want you to use the text box here to describe any kind of response you have that might answer this question. And don't worry about getting this right or wrong. I just want to see what you pick up on. You could always go to the forum and see what other people think about the genetic code too.